Hey, what's up guys, welcome back to the channel. Samsung just announced the Galaxy S20 series and boy it is good, the best smartphone out there, period. But there are a couple of things on which Samsung missed the point. Everyone else will tell you about how good the Galaxy S20 Ultra is, so let me tell you what they missed. So for me, the biggest and kind of the most obvious thing where Samsung missed the mark is the storage. And this is not a nitpick, I am genuinely disappointed. The Galaxy S20 series has the base storage of 128GB, which I guess is fine for the Galaxy S20, and I can live with it also being fine for the S20 Plus, but no way I can let this slide for the Galaxy S20 Ultra. Even the smaller Galaxy Note 10 starts from 256GB, and this behemoth of a phone, the balls to the walls, has just 128GB. It should have been 512GB base variant and a 1TB variant as an upgrade. We all know Samsung can do 1TB on a phone, but 256 should have been at least the bare minimum. 128GB is even found on Samsung's own $200 phone, so man, 128 on a 1400 phone is just an insult at this point. Well, you saw this coming from a mile away, there's no headphone jack. And I get it that it has been gone from some time now, but still, I would have loved to have it and I really miss it. So the biggest thing about the Galaxy S20 Ultra is its ultra price. $1400. 14! That is more than the competitive iPhone for the very first time. In fact, it is $300 more expensive than the iPhone counterpart. That's a huge gap, and I don't know how the average consumer will react to this ultra price. I used to think that OnePlus is increasing the price quickly and will soon reach Samsung's territory. But now Samsung just increased the price so much that OnePlus will have a lot of free space to move around. So one of the biggest issues I had with this smartphone has to do with how it looks. And that, I know, is a very subjective matter. Some people really don't care how their smartphone looks. But I personally, if I'm going to spend $1400, I really want it to look good. This design is the none of smartphones. Samsung managed to go from the best looking smartphone of last year to the worst looking smartphone of this year. That is some achievement. The display in itself is beautiful, the best one present out there, with narrow bezels, quad HD resolution, 120Hz refresh rate and 240Hz response time. But it's almost flat. There is a slight hint of curvature, but it's bare minimum. For some people, it is a dream come true, but I really used to love Samsung's curvature and I wonder where they will go in the upcoming flagships. Will they go completely flat or what? I would love to hear your thoughts on this almost flat phone in the comment section. This is not related to the S20 Ultra smartphone per se, but the fact that it sports 45W charging and we don't get the 45W charger inside the box. We do get the 25W charger and it is plenty fast, but for the $1400 we pay, asking for the damn charger ain't too much. Other than these couple of nitpicks and a couple of serious missed opportunities, I really enjoyed this smartphone. Let me know your most liked and the most hated things about the Galaxy S20 series in the comment section down below. Make sure to subscribe for more coverage on upcoming smartphones. Hit the like button if you enjoyed this video. And guys, thanks for watching.